you so much for coming tonight. It's a pleasure to be here at the Vauxhall Festival. And actually, this is the first time I'm playing with Kate, so this is a really special moment for us. You might have noticed the incredibly ambitious title we gave our concert. So, about 48 hours ago, Christoph and I were walking down the street in Munich and shouting at each other, which is normal actually, but this time because we had to come up with some kind of title for this incredible combination of pieces. But I had a first idea and he had another one, and we couldn't really find consensus. But at the end, we found out that the one thing that all of these pieces share is something very similar to life and how life began. And this is by starting with a small cell, one cell, which then becomes more elaborate and more complex and eventually turns into the world today, which is, it would have been crazy to imagine billions of years ago. So Bach is the master of doing this, starting with the simplest cell possible. And you would have noticed, especially in this last fugue, the subject is so, so simple. It's just a couple of notes, which then he develops into a celebration, really. So the next piece is no different. Bartok opens a completely different world, but you shouldn't be afraid of it. I think sometimes we think of Bartok and atonal music and we become a little bit kind of scared. And I think that the way to look at it is that it's also life. It's an organism like every piece is, but this one is a little bit more foreign. Maybe it's an octopus rather than a cat. So it will take us to a completely different world, but it still has a lot of human emotions which can be sensed, and this work really encompasses an enormous range of expression. And in the second half, we'll play Beethoven's 59 number 2, which is a piece from his middle period, which is where I think he was probably the most romantic. And you can really sense this in this piece of music, which is, he uses a sonata form and takes it absolutely, for the first time ever really you hear such music in history. And what's really special, I find, is in the second movement, he actually gives us several indications. Firstly, we know of a letter that he wrote to a friend of his, where he described this movement as a contemplative walk in the starry night. And for me, that's really special because I think throughout that walk, so many things happen. But if you imagine that you are in that situation, it's very, very relatable. And the other special thing is that he actually, at the beginning of the movement, he says to treat this piece with an enormous sentiment of affection and to have this message from Beethoven 200 years later is extremely special.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.